6 advocates say these small strips help save lives. They are easy to get in Indiana. And tonight, 21 investigates, are they legal to possess? Last year, there were 92 overdose deaths just in Allen County. And advocates say fentanyl test strips could help bring that number down.
Yeah, but 21 investigates reporter Meg Rossler wanted to find out whether it's legal for you to possess them in Indiana. Meg.
Heather and Amr, many nonprofits in Indiana hand the strips out. You can even get them for free by filling out a form online. But the way the law is written is causing a debate over their legality.
It's my understanding that they're used to test the strength of fentanyl in a pill.
According to Indiana code, possessing a device that tests the strength, effectiveness, or purity of a controlled substance could be a Class C misdemeanor.
Do you think possessing fentanyl testing strips is illegal?
Under the Indiana definitions, yes.
Allen County Prosecutor Mike McAlexander says the definition is simple.
Indiana definition of paraphernalia includes anything that can test for the strength of illegal drugs.
So it's not necessarily about illegal or illegal, it's just how that code is going to be locally interpreted.
Brianna Baldwin with the Overdose Lifeline disagrees.
Test strips for fentanyl only test for presence of fentanyl. They don't give you the purity, the strength, or the effectiveness.
Baldwin says the strips save lives.
We have heard countless anecdotal stories from individuals who have used test strips and who have decided right then and there, because they knew fentanyl was in that substance, they were no longer going to use it.
And she says the fear of potentially being prosecuted for possession of test strips is harmful.
That fear and that stigma that an individual who is really looking for resources, who is really looking to make sure that they stay safe and are practicing harm reduction, can be a barrier to actually obtaining test strips and actually using the test strips to make sure that they're safe.
Here in Allen County, would you prosecute a case involving possession of a fentanyl testing strip?
I would certainly look at it, to look at all of those underlying conditions to see if it was appropriate based on the person who was using it.
McAlexander says it's situational.
If somebody is simply doing it to see whether these pills they have fentanyl in it and they want to continue to sell those items, then yes, we would prosecute that.
And prosecuting depends on the intended use of the testing strip.
A baseball bat is a baseball bat if you're playing baseball to hit a ball with. If you use it to hit somebody over the head, then it becomes a crime and can be considered a deadly weapon.
There was an opportunity for lawmakers to clarify the law this past legislative session. It failed in the Senate. Baldwin says she wants people across the state to have access to these resources without question in the future. Reporting in studio, Meg Rossler, 21 Alive News.